Hello, this is Ming. I'm the founder of Aquatic Circle. I'm also the inventor of this water filtration system that can convert your fish tank into an aquaponic ecosystem very easily. Let me show you how this system works and also how you can install it very quickly on your fish tank. This aquaponic system is consisted of two main modules, the in-tank filter and the aquaponic planting tank. This in-tank filter has three main components: a water pump connected to a base, and a mechanical filter just positioned on top of the base. You can remove this mechanical filter very easily just by sliding it sideways like this. In the base, you have a piece of response filter that will serve as a biofilter media for the bacteria to grow on, that won't have to convert ammonia into nitrate that is not toxic to fish. You can customize this mechanical filter very easily by using different types of sponges. In here, there are already two pieces of sponge, the coarse sponge on top and a fine sponge at the bottom. To attach this back on, it's very easy. You can just snap on like this. It will be connected through magnetic connection and self-position itself on top of the base. Let me explain how this filter works. The water pump will pull the water first through the coarse sponge here, and that will trap all the large debris. All the fine debris just goes through here, will be trapped by the finer sponge at the bottom. Any tiny debris that can go through the fine sponge underneath here will go through the biofilter very easily, and also the pump. So that way, the biofilter and the pump will never get clogged. This is the aquaponics planting tank. It has the tank just positioned on top of a shelf. This shelf, you can install it very easily on an edge of your tank. Next step, I will show you how we can convert your fish tank into an aquaponics system using this aquatic circle kit. Before installing the system, make sure that you have enough space at the back of the tank, about 3 inches. If you want to use the lid, just come with the tank. Just place the lid on the tank like this. Take the shelf, make sure that you loosen the screw here to have enough space between the clamps to go through the frame of the tank. You can either do it manually like this, or you can also use the head wrench. Just come with the kit and power tool. Make sure that you set your power tool on lower torque. Now slide the clamps here into the slot, just were designed for the hang on the back filter. Just like this. Hold it in place like this. Now you can remove the lid. Tighten the screw. If you do it manually, it wouldn't be a bit tedious, but it wouldn't work. I prefer to use the power tool. And you can finish by hand. It is actually very sturdy on the back of the tank. Place the planting tank on top of the shelf. Now find a place that you would like to install the in-tank filter. You can install it many different ways. Either at the bottom like this, on the side like this, or this side like this. For now, I just install it right here in this corner. Just press it down for the suction cup to attach to the glass. Set the wire on the side. take the piece of PE tubing just come with the kit, attach it to the inlet of the tank. Measure the length to the outlet of the pump around here. Trim the tubing. Connect the tube to the pump. You can arrange the wire of the pump around the PE tubing. And slide the wire through the space that you have underneath of the planting tank. Now it's really up to your preference. You can put some substrate in here. For now, I just put some sand at the bottom of the tank. You can easily hide this filter behind a rock or some decoration. For example, you can use this rock. Just place it in front like this. Make sure that you still have plenty of space to reach the mechanical filter. Let's fill this tank up with some water. Try not to stir up the sand. I just spray the water on top of the filter. Make sure that you have the filter submerged in water before turning it on. To turn on the pump, you just connect it to the power adapter. Just come with the kit. As you can see that the water is being pumped up to the tank. And we will come down to the main tank through this outlet. Water come back to the tank through the outlet. You can change the water splash direction, almost direction you like. Just loosen this cap and turn this shaft. And remember to retighten it. Continue to fill up the water to the level you like. Next step is to put some plant you like to grow up here. Put the lid on. Put the net pot, just come with the kit, into the slot. There are many types of plants that you can put in here. Example, here's a potas, spider plant, and mint. You just put the cutting in the net pot. Draw the cuttings down. You can use some expanded clay pebble just came with the kit. Now you will need some light to grow these plants. If you install your fish tank next to a well light window, you will need to add grow light on top. But if you have your fish tank in a corner of a room, or in the basement that there's no natural sunlight to reach your plants, you will need to buy this grow light attachment. This will be an add-on to the system. It comes with a retractable light pole that you can adjust the height depending on the grow of the plant. You can attach this light pole on either side of the tank, like this, or on this side. You only need to use the two long screws, just come with the kit. This is a 20 watt LED grow light, full spectrum. It comes with a switch controller that have timer set up on it. Just slide it into the slot on top of the light pole. Fix it with the two short screws that come with the kit. The LED grow light also come with a power supply. Turn it on. It's very bright. With the controller, you can adjust the light intensity. You can also set the timer. I'm going to set about 12 hours per day. Now this tank is ready for fish. As you can see there, converting your fish tank into an aquaponic system is very easy using an aquatic circle kit.